Android One was started as an initiative for the emerging markets, making decent smartphone experience widely available on entry-level and budget-friendly handsets. It has now outgrown its initial target and is ready to confidently step into a mature market with phones like Xiaomi A1. It's a big deal when such a properly equipped package as the Xiaomi A1 is entering the Android One program. We users are lucky enough to enjoy this mid-range smartphone with on-time updates and a pure Android experience. The 5.5-inch LCD screen is a popular choice, while the Snapdragon 625 is still the benchmark for power efficiency. The dual camera is what makes the Mi A1 so attractive, delivering the trending imaging experience on the cheap. Xiaomi Mi A1 has an aluminum unibody design with 5.5-inch IPS LCD display that comes in 1080p resolution with a pixel density of 403 pixels per inch. Android version it comes with is Android 7.1.2 Nougat, which is upgradable to Android Oreo. It comes with Snapdragon 625 chipset with octa-core CPU clocked at 2.0 GHz, coupled with Adreno 506 GPU. As much as memory is concerned, you get 4GB of RAM and 32 or 4GB built-in storage, which can be expanded via microSD card if you are willing to go away with dual SIM functionality. Xiaomi Mi A1 has 5-megapixel front-facing camera which can record videos up to 1080p at 30 frames per second, and dual 12-megapixel back cameras, one with wide-angle f2.2 while the other is telephoto lens with f2.6 for live bokeh effects and dual LED flash. More on this later. Some other specifications include 3080mAh battery which is non-removable and rear-mounted fingerprint scanner. It's a shame that it neither comes with NFC nor the quick charge, and one thing that's confusing is that it has FM receiver but still no FM radio app, and there is no app present at the Google Play Store either to run this hardware, so only way you can listen to radio is by using the service menu. The Xiaomi Mi A1 ships in a plain looking cardboard box with Android One logos all over it. The contents are as basic: a USB Type-C cable, a 5V 2A charger, and there are no headphones or a case included with the box. The Xiaomi Mi A1 design is both traditional and contemporary. The overall impression is indeed very familiar. We can't complain about all metal chassis, which is both premium looking and a sturdy feeling. The Mi A1 follows the company's new design, which is get rid of plastic strips on the back. Now the whole phone is made up of metal and the company has adopted the new less intrusive antenna lines. So whatever color option you choose, black, gold or rose gold, the Mi A1 will look fresh and stylish. The 5.5-inch screen occupies most of the front and has a Corning Gorilla Glass for protection against scratches. The signature capacitive keys are below the display, featuring white backlighting for the button labels. The rest of the Xiaomi Mi A1 is made up of metal with a very pleasant matte finish. The antenna strips run along the top and bottom edge at the back. The fingerprint sensor sits comfortably in the middle, while the dual camera module is bulging in the left corner, but has a nice glossy rim to make that feature instead of a flaw. The fingerprint scanner is always on and very accurate. Upon tapping with a recorded finger, it wakes and unlocks the Mi A1 in a flash. The Mi A1 looks like a typical Xiaomi specimen, even if it doesn't run Mi UI. You'll spot the usual arrangement above the screen, where the earpiece is flanked by a notification LED, a bunch of sensors and the selfie camera. The backlit capacitive keys, task switcher, home and back are below the 5.5-inch screen. The hybrid SIM slot is the only thing that you note on the left side, and it can either take two nano SIMs or you can swap one of those for a microSD card. The volume rocker and the power lock key are on the left side of the Mi A1. Mi A1 also comes with an IR blaster at the top near the noise cancellation mic. The bottom of Mi A1 has the USB Type-C port, the mouthpiece, the audio jack and the loudspeaker. The dual camera is on the back accompanied by dual tone flash. The fingerprint scanner is around too. Xiaomi Mi A1 comes with a 5.5-inch IPS display, which is the same unit we saw on the Mi 5X. A pretty common choice in the Xiaomi smartphones. The sunlight visibility is okay, but overall the Mi A1 suffers from washed out colors under the sunlight. Other than that, you will be able to see comfortably what's happening on the screen. One bad thing that I felt was, even though the screen is 5.5-inch, but even you need some gestures to perform some actions. So this must be kept in mind. Xiaomi Mi A1 runs on vanilla Android version 7.1.2, which is Nougat. Google has promised at least two major updates for the Mi A1, and the Oreo is already here, but it's 8.0, not 8.1. The feature is MIUI UI might be missed by some, but for others it was actually a disadvantage and they will certainly appreciate this pure Android version. The speakers on the Xiaomi Mi A1 are the excellent. The sound is rich and crisp with good bass and clean high notes. The loudness was among the highest I have ever seen in that case. Volume remained just as impressive with headphones and the degradation was minimal too. The Xiaomi Mi A1 has the same 12 megapixel dual camera as the Mi 5X or Mi 6. Unlike the Xiaomi's flagship, the setup on the Mi A1 lacks the optical image stabilization and has lower lenses. The regular wide-angle camera on the Mi A1 has a 12-megapixel sensor with f2.2 lens and the other telephoto sensor has the 12-megapixel with f2.6 lens, close to what Apple used for the iPhone 7 Plus telephoto cam. If you talk about the daylight photos, the Xiaomi Mi A1, just like the Mi 5X, snaps pictures fast, resolves a great deal of detail, and the noise levels are kept reasonably low. The white balance is accurate and I am liking the lively color execution. The dynamic range is good, there is no corner softness either, and the pictures are not over-sharped as the ones shot by the Mi 5X. The telephoto cam also does a great job in good daylight and comes in handy when you need a bit of a zoom. Its quality is close to the main camera, the images have plenty of detail and the same great processing colors and dynamic range. The telephoto lens has a narrower f2.6 aperture and won't do for a low light shots. In those scenes, the phone will stop using the telephoto camera and would instead switch to the cropping the output of the main camera to achieve the zoomed effect. The Mi A1 low light shots came out rather soft. You can see what's inside the picture, but just don't expect much detail when you zoom in. There is a lot of noise. Sometimes I also got blurry images due to the lack of stabilization. So their use is best restricted to the social media. You can record videos at 4K and 1080p at 30fps, while you can record slow motion videos at 720p 120 frames per second. There is no 1080p 60 frames per second mode. The 4K video quality is great, the detail is plenty, the dynamic range is above average. The colors and contrast are very good. The noise is kept quite low and the Mi A1 produces some really nice 4K videos. 1080p videos are not good enough. The level of detail is very low and everything is way over sharpened. It looks like the picture was upscaled from a lower resolution and sharpened. This isn't the first time we have experienced this with Xiaomi, unfortunately. So let's wrap it up, guys. It's a one small step for the Google and one giant leap for Xiaomi. This may be an overstatement, but it really looks like a new page for the Mi line. Android One has been long overdue for a hardware refresh and is better off with this device like the Mi A1. There is no need to sugarcoat the Xiaomi Mi A1. It's a powerful smartphone that clearly is capable of making a difference in this competitive market. It has a premium design, a screen that hits the 5.5-inch sweet spot, a decently powerful and power-efficient chipset, and of course the season's favorite dual camera experience with the portrait shots. With MIUI gone in favor of vanilla Android, users will be getting both the performance boost and a fast track to OS updates. So that's it, guys. Subscribe to my channel and like the video if you like, or dislike if you didn't. See you later. Peace.